Hi friend, today we are solving balancing numerical. Type 2 is a graphical method. Problem is, 4 masses A, B, C and D are attached to a shaft and revolve in the same plane. The masses are 12 kg, 10 kg, 18 kg and 15 kg respectively. And their radii of rotation are 40 mm, 50 mm, 60 mm and 30 mm. The angular position of the masses B, C and D are 60 degree, 135 degree and 270 degree. From the mass A, find the magnitude and position of the balancing mass. At a radius of 100 mm, use a graphical method. Now, we will write first upon given data. Four masses A, B, C and D are attached to a shaft and revolve in the same plane. The masses are 12 kg, 10 kg, 18 kg and 15 kg respectively. Now, M1 is equal to 12 kg, M2 is equal to 10 kg, M3 is equal to 18 kg and M4 is equal to 15 kg and their radii of rotation are 40 mm, 50 mm, 60 mm and 30 mm. Now radii is equal to R1, R1 is equal to 40 mm. R2 is equal to 50 mm, R3 is equal to 60 mm and R4 is equal to 30 mm. The angular position of the masses B, C and D are 60 degree, 135 degree and 270 degree. From mass A, find the magnitude and position. Now, theta 1 is equal to 0. Theta 2 is equal to 60 degree, theta 3 is equal to 135 degree and theta 4 is equal to 270 degree. Balancing mass at a radius of 100 mm. Now radius of balancing is equal to 100 mm and this value is 40 mm is converted into meter. Means R1 is equal to 40 mm is equal to 0.04 meter. Similarly, R2 is equal to 50 mm is equal to 0.05 meter. R3 is equal to 60 mm is equal to 0.06 meter and R4 is equal to 30 mm is equal to 0.03 meter. Radius of balancing is equal to 100 mm. Now is converted into meter is a 0.1 meter. Now to solve the numerical, use the following steps. Step 1 is a draw a space diagram. Now M1 is equal to 12 kg, R1 is equal to 0.04 meter, theta 1 is equal to 0 degree. Now M1 at a 0 degree, theta 1 is a 0 degree. Now R1 is a 0.04 meter, M1 is a 12 kg. M1 at a 0 degree. Similarly, M2 is a 10 kg, R2 is a 0.05 meter, theta 2 is equal to 60 degree. Now theta 2 is a 60 degree, R2 is a 0.05 meter, M2 is a 10 kg. M2 at a 60 degree. M3 is equal to 18 kg, R3 is equal to 0.06 meter, theta 3 is equal to 135 degree. Theta 3 is equal to 135 degree. R3 is equal to 0.06 meter. And M3 is equal to 18 kg. And M4 is equal to 15 kg. R4 is equal to 0.03 meter. Theta 4 is equal to 270 degree. In this line is a theta 4. Theta 4 is equal to 270 degree. R4 is equal to 0.03 meter and m4 is equal to 15 kg. Now we can represent the space diagram. Step 2 is to calculate centrifugal force exerted by each rotating mass on a shaft. Now we know that the calculate of a centrifugal force in a m1 into r1. Now m1 value is 12 kg and r1 value is 0.04 meter. Calculating the values, 12 into 0.04 meter is equal to, we calculate the values, 12 into 0.04 is equal to 0.48 kg meter. Second is m2 into r2. m2 value is 10 kg, r2 value is 0.05 meter. 10 into 0.05 is equal to 0.5 kg meter. m3 is equal to 18 kg, r3 is equal to 0.06 meter. m3 into r3, 18 into 0.06 is equal to 1.08 kg meter. Next is m4 is a 15 kg, r4 is a 0.03 meter. m4 into r4 is equal to 15 into 0.03 is equal to 0.45 kg meter. Now we will draw a length of OA. OA length is a 2.4 centimeter. First, upon take a point O. This point has O. OA length is a 2.4 centimeter. Theta 1 is equal to 0 degree. OA length is a 2.4 centimeter. Next is a theta 2 is equal. Theta 2 is a 60 degree. Now get angle theta 2, 60 degree. Length of AB is a 2.5 centimeter. This angle is a theta 2, is a 60 degree. This length is a AB is a 2.5 centimeter. Theta 3 is a 135 degree. Now we can get theta 3 is a 135 degree. Length of BC is a 5.4 centimeter. This length is a B and C is a 5.4 centimeter. Theta 3 is a 135 degree. Now theta 4 is a 270 degree. Length of C and D is a 2.25 centimeter. This point is a D. C and D length is a 2.25 centimeter. Next is a, now join the first point O and last point D. Join to the first point O and last point D in a dotted line. Now we can complete the polygon for say this dotted line OD is closing side of polygon. Now this line is a resultant of centrifugal force. Now same as this point at a D. Now in this angle is a theta. Theta is equal to 270 degree. Now we can find out the theta. Theta is equal to 270 degree. This line is a balancing force. Now we can draw the vector diagram, complete polygon forces. This dotted line is the resultant of centrifugal force. This line is a balancing of force. Now we can find out the theta value. Theta value is a 270 degree. Step 4 is a calculate resultant of centrifugal force. As per law of polygon forces, resultant centrifugal force can be determined by measuring length of closing sides of polygon. Vector OD is a closing sides of polygon. Length of vector OD is a, now we can measure the length of vector OD. Length of OD is a 3.7 centimeter. Resultant of centrifugal force FC is equal to 3.7 into, now we have considered 1 centimeter is equal to 0.2 kg. 3.7 into 0.2 is equal to, now calculate values. 3.7 into 0.2 is equal to, result of centrifugal value is FC is equal to 0.74 kg meter. Now resultant of centrifugal force is 0.74 kg meter. Step 5 is calculate magnitude of balancing mass. Now MB is equal to magnitude of balancing mass. In order to achieve balancing, magnitude of balancing force is equal to FB is equal to MB into RB. Should be exact equal to magnitude of resulting centrifugal force. Now FB is equal to FC. FB is a MB into RB. FC value is 0.74 kg meter. Now MB into RB value is a 0.1 is equal to 0.74 meter. MB is equal to 0.74 divided by 0.1. Now we find out the MB value, 0.74 divided 0.1. MB value is 7.4 kg. Now we have find out the MB value is equal to 7.4 kg. Step 6 is a find direction and position of balancing mass. In order to attain balancing direction of balancing force and hence balancing mass should be exactly opposite direction to the resultant of centrifugal force. Balancing mass is opposite to the centrifugal force. Therefore, line OD in the vector diagram represents the line of action balancing force and hence balancing mass. Let theta is equal to angle made by balancing force. Hence, balancing mass with the positive x axis theta is equal to angle made by balancing force and end balancing mass with the positive x axis. On measuring theta, this theta is equal to 70 degree. Now we can find the theta is equal to 270 degree. Theta is equal to 270 degree. Thus required balancing mass should lie in of the negative y axis, separating in third and fourth quadrant. Means required balancing mass should lie on the line of negative y axis, separating third and fourth quadrant. Now we have find out the theta value is equal to 270 degree and MB value is equal to 7.4 kg. Thank you.